Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of the Lights Out Cooking Network. Today we are going to be cooking rib eyes on the gas grill. But first, we have to take the beautiful, beautiful rib eyes. We got one with a bone, and we got one boneless. So we're going both ways. Look at these beauties. And we're going to leave them out and let them sit out here for about 2 hours so that they get to room temperature, because you do not want to cook steak right from the fridge to the grill. You need to let them sit out, maintain room temperature, usually about an hour or two, and then you can season them, and then we'll go put them on the grill. All right. Okay, as we're waiting for the ribeyes to come up to room temperature before we cook them, we are going to learn how to make Kathy's world famous Italian dressing. Kathy?
All right, so we start with 3 parts virgin olive oil.
3 parts virgin olive oil.
So we're using that third of a cup, so it'll be about a cup of olive oil. And you can fill it all the way to the top.
So we're doing 3-to-1 basically.
Mm-hmm.
3-to-1 olive oil to
red wine vinegar.
Can you get drunk on this stuff?
No.
Alright. And next.
And so then we are going to add 1/2 teaspoon minced onion, or you can use onion powder.
We're out of the onion powder today, so we're going with the minced onions. And we'll give it a little. Alright, so you got some minced onions.
And then 1/2 teaspoon of the Italian, just any mixed Italian dried herbs.
Italian seasoning,
like Mama Rosie.
Like a Rosie's Italian seasoning. All right, bada bing boom. And this is
That's 1/2 teaspoon.
I don't want to seem like an idiot. This is 1/2, and that's 1/4.
Uh-huh. Okay. And then some sort of salt. Jason has this pretty pink Himalayan salt. So I think we should use that. It's nice and fine.
Oh, we're gonna go heavy on the salt. We got that garlic powder. Then, all right, we're gonna go heavy on the garlic powder. We'd
and
like
then
it.
Only 1/4 teaspoon only of the black pepper, because pepper is spicy.
1/4, 1/4, 1/4, 1/4, 1/4. 1/4, 1/4, 1/4, 1/4, 1/4. Okay. Did we do the pepper? Okay, here we go. 1/4, 1/4. Pepper, because the pepper is strong,
it's
folks.
Strong.
It's a, oh, look at that. There mm-hmm. you go.
And then feel free to season this to taste if you like more of one or the other. And then all you have to do is put the lid on and give it a shake.
Give it a shake, Kathy.
All right.
Show us how you sell this all over the world in all the restaurants worldwide.
Worldwide. Yep. There you go.
Shake it off.
Isn't that pretty though?
Muy bella. Thank you, Kathy.
My pleasure. Always a pleasure, Jason.
And now that we made the salad dressing, we are going to prep the baked potatoes. And a helpful hint, always use your cold water out of your sink, because your hot water actually heats up and it has bacteria in the pipes and stuff, and you don't want that on your food. So just a little helpful hint. We're gonna clean these babies up a little bit. And okay, now we're gonna prep our loaded baked potatoes. Take a little fork, poke some holes in them. Ooh. Don't poke holes in your fingers. Flip them over. Hit them again. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Boom. Next, we're gonna take some olive oil. Extra virgin, and we're gonna give it a little. Oh yeah, we're gonna give it a little of that olive oil, and we're gonna use our los manos, the best tool we have in the kitchen, the hand with the opposable thumbs. Huge, folks, huge. Wrap that olive oil all over the baked potatoes, and we're gonna wash our hands and put some salt and pepper on them. Wash that olive oil off of your hands, and then it's salt and pepper time. Really awesome salt and pepper shakers, Cole and Mason. Love them. Love the Cole and Mason. Put some those babies on. Put some salt on. Flip them over. Wipe the hands. And go for it again. Alright. Take the potatoes, aluminum foil, just cut it into a square, put them in the middle, and just wrap them up. Nice, beautiful little package. Baked potatoes, ready for the grill. All right. All right, let's go check out our brand new gas grill, charbroil. We're about to charbroil. Look at this baby we got. Woo, hot off the press. We just seasoned her yesterday. She's ready to go. Shut her down. We're gonna let the potatoes bake for 20 minutes or so, and then we're gonna throw the ribeyes on, and hopefully they'll both get done right around the same time. So now that we got the baked potatoes on the grill, it is time to season our beautiful ribeyes. We have boneless, and we're gonna utilize the olive oil, salt, and pepper that we used for the baked potatoes on the skin and stuff. Rather than throwing that out, we're gonna use it. Look at this. I'm gonna give them a little dip on each side. Put them on the pan. This is our beautiful ribeye on the bone. We'll give him a little dip. A dip and a flip, as they call it. A dip and a flip. And some salt and pepper. And you can pepper these pretty heavily because a lot of it's gonna burn off on the grill. So even though this looks like a lot of pepper and a lot of salt, it's actually not. Flip them. And pepper the other side. And a little bit of salt. And now it's time to throw some steaks on the grill. Ribeye time, baby. Woo! Alright, let's put these ribeyes on some fire. Woo, this baby's hot. How hot is she? Oh, we're cranking it around 600 degrees, folks. 600 degrees. That's a pretty nice heat. You want to grab them from the sides underneath because these babies are fat. And we're going to throw him. Woo, listen to that. Oh, yeah. She's hot. So we're gonna sear them for about 2 minutes and then we're gonna flip them over. Set your timers. Alright, now it's time to turn them. It's been about 2 minutes. And we wanna keep those cool grill marks. So we're gonna woo! Look at that baby go. Look at them ribeyes go, folks. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. All right, 2 more minutes and we'll be ready to flip them. All right, now it's time to flip them. Ooh, check our grill marks. Because we're trying to win. We're trying to win. We're trying to win the ribeye Florida State Championship coming up. We're training hard here, folks. Oh, look at those grill marks, baby. That is beautiful. That's how you do it. We do like a little angle. 7-11, depending on how you want to count it. Wes says 12 and 8. We're going to close them up. Give them 2 more minutes. All right, and it's time for another move. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, baby. Oh, yeah. Can you smell that? 2 more minutes, and while we're waiting, we're going to turn the left burners down on low. Let them chill out. Cook him for the last 2 minutes. All right. Let's move them. Oh, we're gonna go low and slow. We turn this side off, we got this side on low, and we're gonna go low and slow for about 5 minutes. And while she's cooking slow and low for 5 minutes before we flip her for the next 5 minutes, we might as well turn these baked potatoes over so we get a nice even baking. All right, time to flip them for the last time on slow and low. Let's get a nice flip. They're fat. Oh, they're hard. My arm is just hardened. It's so heavy. All right, and they're, let's see, we're about, probably still about rare right now. So we're gonna go slow and low for 5 more minutes, and we'll be back. All right, let's take a look and see how she's doing. Oh, maybe let's cut her open, make sure. Getting a little dark out here. The sun is setting. I think she's looking pretty good, Wes.
Right around on point.
Oh yeah, perfect. Okay, she's really good. She's really good. So now we are gonna take them off and we are going to let them rest for about 10 minutes because magic happens when you take your steaks and you let them rest for about 10 minutes, sometimes 20 minutes, depending on how you cook them. And what it does is it keeps cooking a little bit more and it traps all the juices in and it's delicious. We got the ribeyes and the baked potatoes. We're gonna let the ribeyes rest now that they're wrapped in aluminum foil. And we're gonna make salad. Let's chop up some salad. Some iceberg. Throw him in there. We got some tomatoes, we'll take some pepper. We got some peppers in there. We got some onions. Alright, we got some onions going on. We got some carrots. These carrots are crunchy. You know carrots are crunchy? They make you see good. Keep the eyesight. So when you turn 28, like I will be next Thursday, you can keep your eyesight going good. All right. So, we got some carrots. Oh yeah, we got a nice salad coming with Kathy's world famous Italian homemade dressing. Some beautiful spinach, homemade Italian dressing. For Rosie. This one's for Rosie from Napoli. Oh yeah, I'll put all the dressing on there. She's beautiful. Tongs. Mix her up and our steak is resting while we're doing this, which is great. We need about 10 minutes. Oh, let's not forget the feta cheese. We'll do a little bit of garlic and the herb, the feta cheese. Oh, look at this. Oh, you gotta love the feta. You gotta love the feta and cheese, folks. Oh, this is a salad. Let's get some pepper on this bad boy. Mix them up. And our salad is ready to go. Oh, isn't she pretty? I think it's time to eat. I think a beautiful, fresh garden salad. Oh, that looks good. Smells good. Kathy's Italian dressing, world famous. So, me and our creative director, Wesley Watkins, are going to eat the boneless ribeye. We're going to save the bone in for another time. So, this is our boneless ribeye steak. That is, ooh, look at that. Well, she has rested for almost 15 minutes. Oh, look at that. Oh. Waste not, want not. Let's check her out. Oh boy, she looks good. Oh boy, she looks good. I'm gonna cut her from top to bottom. Perfect medium rare, a little bit rarer here. And she's a beautiful cut. She's a beautiful cut. Next, we're gonna get our baked potatoes going. Our grilled baked potatoes. Oh yeah. And there's one. And number two coming up. So soft. So tender. Let's cut them open. Let's make some loaded baked potatoes here. Let's pop them open a little bit. We're gonna keep it simple. Butter, sour cream, butter, sour cream. Of course, salt and pepper, and basically everything in your whole life, salt and pepper. And lastly, just to make it really beautiful, let's take some of our chives we got grown in the window. You can take chives right from the grocery store because they have a root, put them in water, and they will actually keep growing, which is amazing. Chives here. Gotta have that green. Gotta have that green. If you know what I mean, gotta have that green. And folks, there you have it. How to cook a ribeye steak on a gas grill, along with grilling some baked potatoes, along with making some amazing garden salad with a homemade Italian dressing. Thanks for hanging out with us today at Lights Out Cooking Network. We'll see you next time.